Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we will see how to create Syncfusion accumulation charts in the React application. Accumulation charts are divided into segments to illustrate numerical propositions, and it has various types, such as pie, donut, pyramid, and funnel. In this video, I will show you how to add a title, data label, legend, and tooltip to these charts. If you want to know how to create a React chart, you can refer to my Getting Started video link in the card above or in the description below. The dependencies of the accumulation charts are the same as the chart control. Now, I will show you how to add an accumulation chart to the React application. I will open my existing application, which already has the chart package installed. To work with an accumulation chart, open the app.tsx file and import the accumulation chart component module from the Syncfusion React Charts package and add the accumulation chart component tag. Let's move on to the chart code. As you know, the chart component is segregated into feature-wise modules. To add a pie chart, I need to import the pie series service from the charts package and inject it into the accumulation chart services. Then, define the accumulation series collection directive tag inside the accumulation chart component tag. Here, I'm going to add a single pie series chart, so I define an accumulation series directive and set its type property with value as pie. Let me now explain how to populate an accumulation chart with data points. I can bind an array of JSON objects or an instance of the data manager to the accumulation chart using the data source property. In this application, I'm going to show mobile browser usage statistics in the pie chart. So, I add the data.js file and define the JSON object as sample data with three fields: name, value, and text. In the app.tsx page, import the sample data from the data.js file and bind it to the data source property. After binding data, I need to set the XY axis to the series. I assign the name field from sample data to the x-axis using the xName property and the value field to the y-axis using the yName property. Let me run this application. Look at the output, a circular pie chart is rendered with the provided data points. And the border will be highlighted on hovering over the slice. You can also provide a piece of information about the data plotted in the pie chart by adding a title. To provide the title to the pie chart, I include the title property and set its value to mobile browser statistics. Notice here, the title has been added to the pie chart. Now I will show you how to add data labels to improve the readability of a pie chart. To do that, I import the accumulation data label module from the chart package and inject it into the accumulation chart services. Then in the accumulation series directive, add the data label property and enable the visible option. And to display the custom label value inside the pie chart, include the name property and map the text field from the JSON object. Then to position these labels inside the chart, include the position property and set its value to inside. As you can see, the data labels are displayed inside the pie chart. Next, I will show you how to set a legend to the pie chart. A legend provides information about the data points rendered in the pie chart. To enable it in the pie chart, import the accumulation legend module from the chart package and inject it into the accumulation chart services. Check the output, legends are shown on the right side of the pie chart. You can also customize the legend position by including the legend settings property and specify the legend position as bottom. See here, the legend is shown at the bottom of the pie chart. Now, I'll show you how to enable tooltips on the chart when showing data labels takes up too much space. To add tooltip, import the accumulation tooltip module from the chart package and inject it into the accumulation chart services. Then include the tooltip property in the accumulation chart and set the enable option value to true. Check now, tooltips are shown when I hover over the data points in the pie chart. Let's see how to render a donut chart. You can easily convert pie charts to donut charts by specifying the inner radius property and setting its value more than 0%. You can specify the value between 0% to 100%. For now, I specify the inner radius as 50%. Look at the output. Browser usage statistics are displayed by using the Doughnut series. Next, I will show you how to render a pyramid chart. Let me change the Pi series module to pyramid series in the import statement and accumulation chart services. Then in the accumulation series directive, change the type property value to pyramid. See, the pyramid chart is rendered, and the data labels are shown outside the chart for better visualization. Finally, I will show you how to render a funnel chart. Let me change the pyramid series module to funnel series in the import statement from the chart package and inject it into the accumulation chart service. Then in the accumulation series directive, I change the type property value to funnel. Look at the output, a funnel chart is rendered. Let me quickly summarize. You've learned how to create accumulation charts like Pi, Doughnut, Pyramid, and Funnel. You have also learned how to add a title, data label, legend, and tooltip to these charts. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.